Hey everybody, it's Shisha here from SalesforceWay.com. In this video, we're going to talk about how to create the Apex wrapper for the custom metadata types. In the previous video, we talked about why it is important to create such a wrapper for both the custom settings and the custom metadata types. And also, we did the hands-on to create such a wrapper for the custom settings. So if you haven't watched the previous video, I will put the video link in the information box. You can click the information and get to that video, or also down below in this video description. Because in that video, we went into a lot of details about the design patterns and a lot of useful detailed information. So in this video, we're going to quickly just talk about the difference between the two wrappers for the custom settings and metadata types. We will go much faster, okay? With that said, now let's dive into coding. All right, now I have fired open the Visual Studio Code and loaded the same project that I used in the previous video. So I've also created all the content that I need for this video. As you can see, first of all, we created the wrapper for the custom metadata type. This is the meat of this video. We're going to quickly go through it in a minute. And in addition to that, we have created the custom metadata type with two very simple fields. One is Boolean, one is text, just for the demonstration purpose of this video. Now let's look at the code in this custom metadata type wrapper. So you might have noticed that the design pattern is very similar to the previous one we did for the custom settings. So I've also opened this custom setting wrapper here, aligned with the metadata type wrapper. So it used the very similar logic, is that it used the getconfig to route according to whether it's the testing code or it's a production code. And then it has a public property which maps, one-to-one maps to the custom metadata type field. So this is exactly the same design pattern, but there are some minor changes here. First of all, as you can see, the custom metadata type, in order to read a record, you have to use a suckle, which is different from the previous one. And in addition to that, there's one thing you need to be aware of, is that there's no way for us to either create a new record or update the existing record from Apex code. That's a limitation in the Lightning platform. As of today, I don't know if it's going to be changed in the future, but as of today, you cannot create or update metadata type record from the Apex. And because of that limitation, as you can see, this code, there's no database.insert. In the custom settings, in the production code logic, we can do a database insert. But in the custom metadata type, there's no way for us to do that. So I just ignored that in the production code. And then in addition to that, we created the so-called cached config. Is, if you can see, it's different, actually slightly different from the test config. The test config is mainly used by the test code only, but the cached config is used for both the production and the test code. This is something you're going to spend your own time to have a look at, and what is the difference between the cached config, because it's the subtle difference. And in my opinion, at least one of the benefits is that it can save some suckle against the metadata type in the same execution thread. But be aware that even if you save the suckle read execution, it does not save the governor limits against the DML, because reading metadata type, the suckle query, does not count against the DML governor limit, which is a very good thing for us to use the custom metadata type for the settings of your application. So with that said, the other parts of this wrapper is exactly the same as the custom setting wrapper we did for the previous one. So this is all the things I want to talk about the custom metadata type. So you can see that it's very easy. It's very similar to the previous design pattern. I hope you can adapt this design pattern to create the wrapper in your future project. It can save a lot of hassles. And if you like this video, hit the like button and also don't forget to subscribe to this channel and join our family. And that's the end of this video. See you next time.